गुड आफ्टरनून मा, वेलकम टू आलफा ऑनलाइन एजुकेशन कॉमर्स थियरी पार्ट फॉर द सेकेंड ईयर्स इंग्लिश मीडियम। द चैप्टर दैट वी आर डीलिंग विद दैट इज द 8th चैप्टर इंटरनेशनल ट्रेड। International trade, and this is the first session of the chapter. So here we are going to discuss about the internal trade and the international trade. What are the differences between these two types of trade? Let us see. Internal trade means the trade which is done within the country, that is an internal trade. Okay, international trade means the trade which is done with several countries. Okay. With several number of countries, the trade is known as international trade. When the trade is done within one country, within the home country, that is known as internal trade. So, why we do the international trade, we will know later. Before that, what is the differences between the national internal trade and international trade? So, internal trade refers to the trade within the country. Yes, internal trade refers to the trade within the country, whereas international trade refers to the trade outside the countries or the trade with several other countries, that is known as international trade. Next, no exchange of currencies. There is a no need for the exchange of currencies when we are doing the trade within our country, because whatever the exchange transactions are done, those transactions are done within our country currency. Okay, we no need to exchange our currency into dollar or in any other country currency, euros or anything. But here in the international trade, exchange of currencies is a mandatory, because it is the trade which is going to be happened between two different countries. So two different countries have two different currencies. At the time when the exchange of goods and services takes place, at the time the exchange of the currency is also become a mandatory subject. Next, third one, there will be no restrictions. So here there will be no restrictions at all. So how much you want to trade, how you want to trade, okay, there will be no much restrictions. Restrictions will be there, but not that much restrictions, which are we will see in the international trade. There is a lot of restrictions in the international trade, okay, because it is a trade which is doing with some other country and home country. Home country and host countries are present here. That's why the trade is taken place between the two different countries. So there will be number of restrictions between the exchange of goods. Scope for demand and supply forces. There is a scope for the demand. The customer demand type of products are prepared, and those products are supplied on the force of the customer. Whereas come to international trade, scope for demand and supply force are restricted. There will be no demand at all, and there will be no force for the supply. Okay, if they want to supply, they will supply. If they have plenty of that material or plenty of that product, then they will only supply. We can't demand for them for supply, and we can't force them to supply. Okay, so there is a lot of restrictions for the demand and supply, but within the country there is no restrictions on the demand of the customer, on the force of the customer, the product is supplied to the customer. Transport cost and risk are less. Here the transport is taking place within the country by roadways or by railways. So the cost is very less and the risk is also very less comparing with the international trade. Whereas come to here in international trade, the transport system cost is very more, and the risk factor is also very high, because they can use the railways, waterways, seaways in order to transport the goods. So the transport cost is more, and there is a risk of losing of the good also. So that's why in the international trade they generally take the insurance. Transfer of goods within the home country from the place of production to consumption. As you all know, the production takes place in one particular place, but the customers or consumers are spread all over the country. So the transportation of the good from the place of production to the ultimate customer takes place within the country in the internal trade. Whereas come to the international trade, the production takes place in the home country and the distribution takes place in the host countries. Okay. So transportation of goods outside the home country, the production will takes place within the home country, but the customers or the consumers are spread all over the world. Okay. There are spread all over the world. So that's why they have to move from one place to another place, from one country to another country, and they have to travel to several countries in order to supply that product to the ultimate customer. Benefit of specialization within the country. So if there is any specialized persons or specialized skills are there that can be utilized for the development of country in the internal trade, that will be utilized within the country. But here the benefits of specialization derived by all the trading countries, okay, that will be derived, that will be used by all the trading countries, the specialization. Whereas come to in the internal trade, that specialization is used within the country. Whereas come to international trade, that specialization will be used by all the countries. The movement of the goods depend upon the internal transport system. So the movement of the goods, that will completely depend upon the internal transport system. But here the movement of the goods, that is takes place by railways, roadways, waterways, airways, that is completely depend upon these. Yes. Next, the volume of the trade depend upon the size of the population, volume of the production and other supporting facilities. So the volume of the trade, how much we have to trade, how much it is necessary to trade, that will be completely depend upon the size of the population or the volume of the production. If it is a scarcity resource, then very low quantity of production is made, and further the demand will be more and the price will also be more. Okay, that will be completely depend upon the size of the population, the availability of that particular material and some other supporting facilities. Based on that, the volume of the production will be depend upon. But here there are restrictions imposed on the free entry of goods. So when the goods are importing from other country, there will be certain restrictions. Okay, there is no free entry for the goods to be entered in the other country. Goods from other country can't be entered into our country freely. Okay, there are certain restrictions are imposed on that kind of entries, and duties and taxes are to be paid. So there are certain restrictions, certain taxes you have to pay, and certain duties also you have to be paid in order to enter that product into your country. The volume of the trade depend upon these factors. So the trade factor completely depend upon these goods. Free entry of goods is restricted, duties and taxes, on these the volume of the trade is completely depend upon. Okay, so these are the major differences between internal and international trade. Yes, let us move on to the importance of the international trade. What is the importance of making the international trade? Let us see. See, no country in the world is self-sufficient. So no country have all kinds of resources or all kinds of materials. So no country is self-sufficient with all kinds of goods and services. Yes, in the other words, no country can produce all the goods required. So no country can produce whatever the goods it required. No country has such a capability to produce all the goods by itself. So ultimately by this, it is one thing is clear here, every country have to depend upon other country for certain resources. Yes, in order to get certain types of goods, every country is depending on other country. If we take Saudi Arabia, it is depending, we are depending upon the Saudi Arabia for petroleum. Yes, so in this way, every country is depending upon our country. Okay, they are also depending upon water from other country. In this way, there is certain type of dependency between the countries. International trade is the backbone of our modern commercial world. So international trade has become a backbone. Where will be your backbone? On the back side. Okay. So there will be a backbone. So it is very much important. With the backbone only we can stand. If we don't have backbone, we can't able to stand. In the same way, in order to stand the commercial world, the international trade is very much important. It acts as a backbone. International trade broadens the mental outlook of the people. It encourages them to think and act beyond the narrow conferences of national consideration. So international trade, here the people will encourage the international companies in order to introduce new types of products. By that, the people, what they are wishing from these MNCs companies, they can get from these international trades. Next, what is the scope of the international trade? This is very important topics. Differences and the scope. Importance, very important concepts. International commerce and trade theories. In the scope of the international trade, what are the concepts are covered? Let us see. International economics and trade theories. There are certain trade theories are there. Based on that, the trading should be done. Okay? International economics. International economics is also considered while doing the international trade. Quantitative techniques for foreign trade. While doing the foreign trade, certain quantitative techniques are used in order to solve the problems which are arise in the research. Global business communication and public relations. So global communication means total globe is covering by these international trade. And they are making communication with them, with the several countries and the people of that several countries. They will maintain the relations. By that only they can do the international trade. Computer application in foreign. Computer application in the foreign trade. So nowadays everything is going on computerized. So obviously the foreign trade is also going on in a computerized way. Insurance and risk management in the foreign trade. So insurance is given in order to manage the risk which is involved in the foreign trade. International marketing management and consumer behavior. So there is an international marketing way for what kind of goods there is a market internationally, and also what is the consumer behavior, how the consumer is behaving according to the international products, whether he giving importance to it or ignoring it. So that is also considered. International human resource management on organizational behavior. So international human resource management. So internationally, what kind of people should be there at the workplace and how much skill is required for them and how the organizational behavior means the attitude of the persons who are working in these international trade and their behavior and their psychology, that all things are considered while doing the international trade. International business law. So while doing the international business, there are certain acts, certain sections are there that will be in the international business law. The law indicates the rules and regulations. Export and import finance. So while exporting the goods, the finance is given. While importing the goods, also the finance is given. Foreign exchange and exchange control. Okay, foreign exchange, when we are exchanging with one country, with other country, and also controlling certain types of exchanges. Export incentives, motivating the exporting of goods. When we are exporting more goods, then it indicates that our country is developed country. Export pricing, so how should be the price of the things what we are exporting to other country. These are the scope of the international trade. So let us meet in other session with the other topic, right?